wanted to relax my snacks. I woke up with about 30 pounds of anxiety this morning. Ugh. It was really, really intense. It was a lot. And Brandon had the idea, because I just need to, like, I was, like, shaking and fidgeting, trying to get the energy out, because it was a lot of, just a lot inside my chest and my heart. And Brandon said, why don't you maybe just come with me and take me to work, and then you can go to the wash and walk. And I'm like, you're right. It's not very likely I'm going to be able to go back to sleep anyways. So I did. And I took him to work. And I came to the wash. Cañada del Oro. It's beautiful here. And walking did indeed alleviate my anxiety. And finally, I found a good spot in between these two Palo Verde trees. And I set up my camp and my hammock. And my anxiety has come back a little bit, but it's interesting because the void, the open emptiness within my vessel, within my soul, it opened back up. Part of it could be because I just have so much anxiety and there's a conflict going on. So I'm just trying not to ruminate and go with the flow and woo way. And I am. For the most part, I'm doing quite well. But the emptiness has risen up again, and I feel it, and it's interesting because you can't really see an emptiness and feel the emptiness, but I know it's there. But if I know it's there and it's emptiness, then is there really anything there at all? What is it that causes the emptiness? Because I'll tell you what, I've been communicating with a handful of people today. And there's been my sister, there's been Brandon, there's been Lolly. There's been Aza, there's been khefreun, there's been Stanley. A lot of good, lovable people. And, who love me. They all love me so much. Wow, that's so nice that many people really care about me. And it's interesting because, for some reason, although all those people care about me, there's still that emptiness. And that's completely okay. The emptiness it could be filled temporarily by people, but even still, I'm still getting all these lovable messages. But it ain't filling my emptiness, because the emptiness is it's deeper than that, and it's my emptiness. It's nothing to do with them. And, so, it's just interesting, because I haven't told anyone about the emptiness that is within me that has risen up today. They know that I've had the anxiety, but part of it, I think, is I don't want them to know right now, because I want to continue to prove to myself that I can handle the emptiness on my own, and I can fill the empty void on my own, because really, ultimately, that's all there is to it. No one can fill the void except for myself, long term. And so I'm here. See, people are messaging me. It's a lot of people. I don't know who it is. But there's so many people who love me, and I love them. And I'm reading the book that khefreun gave me, and it's interesting. It's got good stuff about let me get my post-its. Let's see what I wrote. Okay. So I started writing about the darkness. They kind of got out of order. Ready? So here's the darkness. I opened the book, but I just was feeling the emptiness, and I'm like, the emptiness, I don't even want to read. And then the first picture in the book is like this god or something with a huge hole in their chest, like the one that I'm drawing and how I depict my emptiness. And I was like, no, there I am, that's exactly like me. And so I wrote, there is an open, empty wound screaming inside me. It hurts, but I can't tell it to stop. Because if I tell it to stop, that's resisting what is, and that's not allowing myself to feel the void. There's a big void, and maybe I'm just filled with emptiness because I just ain't eating enough. So if I eat enough, then I'll have fullness. I have to feel it. I have to. I don't have a choice. I am so lonely inside of me. I just want someone to jump in. But the only one who can jump in is me. And I can fill my emptiness. Because, you know what? I'm the closest to the emptiness compared to anyone else. Compared to the tree, compared to the grass, compared to the mountain, compared to the cholla, compared to the sand, compared to those ants and the fly. The closest thing to the emptiness is me. And I can jump inside of my own emptiness and fill it. People can fill it temporarily, but not permanently. It hurts. Why do you rip my hole open wider? And that's talking to people who say things that hurt my feelings. But everybody's human, so it's completely okay for everyone to say whatever they're gonna say, and it's just my ability to handle. But it feels like when something happens or someone says something, that it feels like my hole's like just getting ripped open, like you're ripping open my chest. And these are from the book. I don't know where this one is. It says, I am not my thoughts. I'm not sure where that fell into the chronological order. Be like a little child. Enter the kingdom of heaven. Curious, wide-eyed, believing, trusting. The potter becomes the pot. I become what I make. So if the potter becomes the pot, and they are what they make, and they put their energy into what they make, and their attention, and if I put my energy and attention into what I make, which is, for example, setting up this beautiful little spot to hang my hammock, I become the hammock, and I become the trees, and I become the sand. I become the ants. And if I make a vlog, I become the vlog. I am the vlog. This is my vlog. This is my hammock. These are my trees. This is my air. This is my sky. But then again, none of it really belongs to me at all anyways. So it's like I am all the things, but I am none of them at the same time. Inside me is a heart cave. I watch the drama of my life with unbearable compassion. I like that, because it's like, oh, Rachel, your life's a drama. Oh, I feel it. I feel the pain of your existence. I feel the pain of your life, Rachel. Oh, little Rochi, it's okay. It's just a drama. It's just a movie. I have unbearable compassion for my pain. I am just inside here watching with great awe and wonder. And when I think of it like that, and when I can think about everything that I experience and see with great awe and wonder, I am human. I don't know. There's nothing. I have no answers for anything. I just experience and I watch with great awe and wonder. Maybe if I were beyond human, maybe I am beyond human. Because deep within this human vessel is something. What is it that's peering out through these eyes? What is this consciousness? There's something in here. And the something in here is speaking to you now. Watch the awesome drama of nature unfold before my very eyes. And this reminds me of when predators are attacking prey. Because that is a drama. That is a huge drama in nature. Man, these ants, they're working so hard. There's like so many ants by my iPad. Right next to where you're viewing from. There's ants everywhere, and they're all just carrying little leaves. They're pretty dramatic too. They're so diligent and hardworking. And that's not the first time I've talked about ants in these videos. When I am with a candle flame, I am the candle flame. When I am with a tree, I am the tree. I am everything. If there is a task to do, I am the task. The art of doing nothing, let the task complete itself. So you just do it effortlessly. Are these ants being effortless? If they have a hive mind, then are they really controlling themselves at all? Or are they just going with the motion, the movement of what they're being fed? Same with us. If there's a collective consciousness, then are we part of a hive mind? There is no attachment. Memento mori. Remember, everything passes and you are borrowing everything that you see, that you experience from the angel of death. Nothing is permanent. Everything will change. Everything will disappear. Everything will pass on. Memento mori. What about the vastness of space? And outer space, the blackness, the emptiness. Will that disappear? Or is that entirely incapable of being part of the memento mori, since the vast emptiness, is it nothing? Or is the vast emptiness something? Because if the earth can disappear and the stars can disappear and little molecules can change and disappear, transform, or whatever, what about nothingness? I guess for the emptiness of space to disappear would mean that it would need to be filled. So if the emptiness of space became filled with something solid, memento mori for the space, that's an interesting concept. I can see patterns unfolding. And that one reminds me of Stan. He's always looking and paying attention to the details and the patterns and everything that happens, is seeing signs and symbols. Just like I do. Except mine isn't always with numbers. But now it's becoming with numbers. I understand. I am without form, beyond space, beyond time. I am everything. Everything is me. In this journey, I must die. So I go through this entire existence. This physical form will die. And then, will it go on? Where will the spiritual form, where will it go next? Once I pass away. Something earlier, I forget where I saw it on that there was some Instagram person that khefreun recommended for me to look at. It's an energy, never disappears, it just goes on. So when you die, the energy within you will then carry on. Even the physical energy. I'm watching a baby bunny rabbit and a chipmunk deteriorate and get absorbed back into the earth at my work. I've watched the chipmunk, I think, since the day it died. I scooped it out of a pond tank and set it down next to where I found this dead bunny. And so they're right next to each other, going through this process together. And the energy which they are is either being dried up by the sun, or it's being fed to little creatures, little flies and larvae, and their physical energy is transferring on. And then the nutrients of their decaying body is being absorbed back into the ground. And then what? When they decay enough, then I will collect their bones. And I will have little chipmunk and bunny bones. And then I will use their energy further. And I will draw on the wisdom from what their remains have to offer. And if their spirit lingers there, what does the spirit have to offer? Or has the spirit already continued on? Now that I've talked for 21 minutes, I must get up to stop the recording. I love you. I have the urge to say, be sure to like and subscribe, but it seems so superficial. Who cares? I'm making these videos for me anyways. Clearly it's helped fill my emptiness. To talk and express these ideas. See? I can fill my own emptiness. Did I read these ones? I did. Alright. And so it is.